What's going on, everybody? This is Kaleem Poole, aka Kal One. You know what the deal is. So we are joining again right now for our game of, well, we're just going through some games right now. It's been a short while since we got some streams going on. So I wanted to get some arcade gaming going, maybe a little bit of sim racing. But right now we're just chilling out, warming up after midpoint of a pretty hectic week. It's been a good week though. So what's up, guys? Thank you for tuning in. Before we get started, of course, you know, got to do the routine of the like, share, and subscribe. So please put the notification and the bell on the bottom of your screen. And yeah, that's pretty much it. So we're going to make sure that the stream is going copacetic, and it seems like it is, so that's good. And yeah, so welcome. We're just jumping in right now. I'm going to get some, some driving done. But I'm just having more fun with getting to know the wheel more. The whole structure of how everything works. And just getting used to the power and torque and handling of each and every vehicle, which I will admit, when you get a little desensitized to it when you're on a controller. So it's definitely good to get it out there on the wheel, so to speak. So let me get a little bit of sharing of this first. And started. Always nervous. I'm always nervous, but I'm still getting used to everything. I'm spreading around now. About getting the stream up on YouTube. Let's see what we got. What do I want to use? Something simple. Just to get warmed up. M3, the big ass wing. I did all kind of craziness with these vehicles, but now I understand what to do and what not to do, so to speak. Let's try this classic. I just got everything running on, should be about 1440p resolution now. To get past the 1080p, I wanted to start getting higher quality imaging offline and online. So that is the deal at the moment. Soon as we get the stream going, here we go. Okay, cool. So we up and running. So let's share this out. Back up and running, bro. Definitely got to get a new thumbnail. I already started to change the logo, so you're going to see it when I do the offline of this. It's going to be different. More themed according to what it is that I'm doing here, really. Let's get this up. I like to do it on erasers first because it's my favorite forum. They already know. Back in the driver's seat. I was going to say in the saddle. Okay, let's paste this up. Bong. Racing game carousel. As I like to call it. I'm just cycling through a number of games. No necessarily rhyme or reason. Racing games. Say arcade. That is not how you spell arcade. Sim racing. All right, that should be good. What is this woman doing? Aw, cutie. Lord. said, have fun. I'm trying. Just starting it up. Stress. Not really. All right, so we're just going to chill. I'm going to try with this BMW. Probably got no business using this shit, but we're going to go for it anyway. Because we're ignorant. All right, what's my buttons of Forza again? All right. Remember, I used to really like this. I mean, I still kind of do this POV, but not as much in Forza now because I can't really control it. Plus, the wheel isn't necessarily one-to-one to the actual wheel here. But it's still fun. I'm going to have to turn this music off. Okay. Okay, that's the area. Okay. So I'm like, I thought I had the music off. Alright. Let's get some warm-ups. Never driven this car before. Let's not stress it out. We don't know what we're doing yet. Yeah, this is... Remember, I used to do this a lot just on regular Xbox. What? Oh, regular Xbox. Just with the controller. And I got addicted to it with Forza Horizon 4. Mostly with the environments, just driving around and having fun with everything. But now with the wheel, it's a very obviously a different experience overall. I know I'm driving super conservative now because I'm just trying to get used to the grip and physics dynamics again, this game specifically. Alright. So my settings here are like around the high medium at 1440p. I have certain things at ultra that I think I should be, like, you know, car models, texture work. The shadows I have at like high or medium high. The LODs and the other objects I have them are around medium high also. So, whoa, pretty, you know, good. Everything, as you can see, is like 60 and up. Forza Horizon 5 is pretty taxing. So, I always like how they made able to make everything scale real well. Without having to break the bank with your GPU. They've always been real good at that, and that's what we're kind of hoping will be the difference they're going to finally optimize for Forza Motorsport 8, but different team, different standards, you know. They share assets, but not exactly the same type of workflow, you know, so it's different. We got to deal with it, so at least with Forza Horizon, it can almost run enough. Freaking potato. Now, you can still play Horizon 5 on your original Xbox One. You know? First gen, like 1080p first gen. That's how the game is optimized. You know, they scaled it really well. Okay, this likes to slip a lot, so I gotta be careful with the wheel and going back once I get the corner. Back to straight, and I can't just throw it because it'll just slip out, it feels like. That is the portions where it makes it feel like it's Simcade, because, you know, true arcade game doesn't have this many technical dynamics with control. They just don't. True arcade game is very simple with the way it controls. So, yeah. This is definitely... Well, I also did put the control at simulation for Forza standards anyway. So you do feel it a lot more versus, I guess, if you left it on pure arcade control standards, then, you know, it'd be more forgiving. Alright. Also, I turned everything up on the wheel for this game to 100, so even with this 5 newton meter wheel, I feel everything. Still feel everything. I wanted it to be as strong as when I'm playing Assetto Corsa, because once you go there, it's hard to go back. You just can't really do the weak wheel feeling, so to speak. See, if I do the corner too quick, it'll swerve out. You saw that, right? Start floating. You gotta be careful. Careful. This will throw me right off. fast and a little quicker now. Always remember, where your eye goes is where you're going. Where your eye goes is where you're going. So if I keep looking that way, I'm gonna slip that way. If I look this way, I'm gonna go that way. Try to keep tricking my brain. Look in the direction you wanna go, and that's where the wheel will go. Feel that slip. This thing has no downforce. It's quick, but it has no downforce. So you better slow the hell down in these corners or you're gonna fly off into them. So they gotta be real conservative with that braking. Plus also the tires. I think these are the default tires. I kind of just took this out like just broad butt naked, so I don't know what I got going on body-wise. Okay, I think I'm going to upgrade this now. Get a nice little warm-up, right? Should be good. Push, 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 push. Why is my foot so far down on the pedal? It's supposed to be up ahead. There we go. Yeah, the sense of speed is, you know, variable depending on the car, but you definitely feel it through the wheel. So it's like you either want to be real risky or real conservative depending on what you're trying to accomplish. See, my frame rate's dropping here because we're in open world, so it's always going to be rendering a lot more. But it just goes right back up. Aha, 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 that's what I get, that's what I get, that's what I get, that's what I get. No grip there. But we still got it. Oh, that float. Oof. That was a bit crazy. Whoa, cannot turn that wheel too much. That's nice though. All right, so we're gonna see what this is like now with some upgraded parts. Let's go back to my thing. Upgrade this and see how we can make it improve a little bit more so it's not so sloshy. All right, upgrades and tuning. Okay, so I immediately go to auto upgrade for all the basic stuff to see what I'm dealing with here. And it maxes out at what, more or less? 340 is good. Lose 300, that's good. Not responding to that. Oh, I just got really hungry. I didn't eat my whole sandwich. Custom greed. All right. Absolutely need downforce because you. Yeah, front splitter also. It's more for the front than the rear. Okay, we got a dovetail, so that's good. And this is just to remove that for weight. Why not? Okay. Engine swap. No, I'm going to leave it. Tires. What tires am I working with here? Semi slicks. Yeah, leave it as semi. I just want to see everything before I max out like that. Okay. Wheel width, of course. As possible. Track width, make it wide body. Thank you. Change the wheels because this is not going to work. Something simple, I guess. Simple ish. Those are nice. Damn, 16 is good. 15. Mm-hmm. Oh, no, 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 go back. 15. There we go. Install. Yes. All right, so I got semi-slick tires. Wait, ah, shit, I didn't change the LSD. The limited differential. I only got 1 million credits. I really don't play this game that much. Like, I got a bunch in Forza Horizon 4, but 5 kind of feels like 4.5, and I do enjoy it, but, you know, it's one of those, I've been here before, so I'm not as enthusiastic as I did, as I was before. Sport transmission, no, we need race, thank you. What you just tried to stick me with. Okay. Check my brakes now that I know that you tried to shrimp out and everything else. Race springs, okay. Okay. Full roll cage, please, thank you. Okay. My bar weight reduction is maxed. That is it. Okay, now we're good. Okay, now let's try her out now. First thing we're going to do is increase that rear downforce. That's the first thing. Just good God. Please then. Thank you. All right. We're going to leave. Yeah, 50-50. We're going to leave everything like this first. Camber. Yep, negative camber, please. Da-da-da-da-da, rear. Dot. I'm gonna leave the toe and everything as is for now. Oh, wait. Yes, there we go. There's the wrong button, just make sure everything okay. Tire pressure. It's bit. Da-da-da-da, springs. I'm leaving for now. We got the air. Okay, cool. Alright, let's try her out. Now, it should slip less in the rear, from the rear. Keyword is should. Already feels a little bit more stable. I mean, quicker, obviously. Faster, obviously. Oh, yeah, much better. Yeah, I feel like now I can put my foot down on the pedal more. Yeah, now the car doesn't feel like it's trying to kill me. And we got some GT style aero going on, so that helps a lot. Now we just gotta be careful where the hell we're going. I like this better. Using a wheel, I'm actually depending on the dash, and the wheel animation is cool, but it's not as one-to-one as it is in a Assetto Corsa, and I can't adjust the FOV as much, so that is what it is there. This feels great now. Braking is better because of the aero, everything's better. Aero makes everything better. Even if you just got a little bit, it still makes it better. Much better. Not as scared of the acceleration now. Trying to cut that corner. That was too much. I just wanted to see how far I could go. You feel that power though. 300 horsepower doesn't sound like it's a lot, but it's you feel it. Especially when everything is set serious with the aero and the control. You feel it now. Well, you feel it. Frame rate drop, major frame rate drop there. But I am also streaming from the same hardware. Oh shit. And also I'm in open world mode, so it's more taxing. I love the objects in Forza so much. More stable, even with the extra speed. Nice. Whoa. I can never tell if I'm slower or if I'm just being more cautious, which might be one and the same, or it could all just be in my head. Drifting area, that's not happening. I don't drift. But they do give you a strong racing line here, though. Which, you know, technically would still be the same line for drifting, right? Definitely, like, I put the strength and dampening on the wheel. It makes it much better to control. I can feel the resistance of the tires now on the surface. Oh, player. Oh, get it. Come on. Good girl. Oh, I love the way that feels, that resistance. You feel all the gravel, everything. Whoa, that was risky. I just wanted to see if I could do it. Dizzying ass mountain, that's for sure. Oh, that's total cheap. Did I? Mm-hmm. am still happy that I got this wheelbase, seriously. Like, I could have gotten the Logitech G series, and as much as I, you know, I respect that, I didn't want it. And the Moza is equal to, but they're more pricey. So Fanatec, or is it Fanatec? I never know if I'm getting it right. We're really smart with this package deal. Now it has it where I want to get the additional wheels to go with the wheel base, like the GT3 wheels. Like, of course, the McLaren one. It's real popular, with good reason. All right, let's do something stupid. Yeah! Oh, Jesus. Feel all of that. That was just violent. That was just beautifully violent. Keep forgetting which is my button for exchanging the camera. Well, that's not it. That's the rewind. There we go. Gotta remember. It's the plus sign, plus sign, plus sign. And my car is ruined so beautifully. All right, shut in the car. We'll just go to my horizon. Okay. I can't tell why the mouse is being so unresponsive here. All right, so this is a quick test. We're going to jump on again later. Let's do a little bit more of this. I'm starving. So we'll be back on. Just going to try something else real quick. What was it? Jump to manufacturer. No. Just remember what button it was on here. Ooh, that's not the one I wanted either. There we go. No, it's not it either. There we go. All right, so yeah, buttons, obviously, because they're all numerical. It's not like there's, you know, X, Y, B, A on here. So I have to remember how it's set.
Plus, also, I didn't set it.
I just wanted to see if it was working, and I just jumped right in. All right. Oh, yeah, that stomach is saying, what are you doing to me right now? And the classic Supra, Celica Supra, because I was brain damaged with that one. This one I know controls really well. 92 Super GT. I don't feel like going super fast. Flake it. This is basically a GT vehicle where I have it tuned up. And I wish I didn't have to have the huge, gigantic chassis mounted spoiler. It doesn't really need to be that large. Plus, it's double spoiler based, so. It's a little goofy. Oh, that speed difference. Get used to the brakes, because the brakes are much more powerful. You've arrived at your destination. This is a test track. I forgot about this. Test everything. Just go left. Super conservative. Did not need to go that hard on the braking. It's a very different feel from the last. Good. probably would break better if my whole foot was on the brake. Watch that. Could not see over that hill. That's what I do like about the free roaming in Forza. It just keeps you on your toes, so to speak. Be ready for anything. These are not set courses, so I just get used to the feel of every vehicle and learning how to adapt. I feel like I'm always driving to the stadium just to run in a circle, get bored, and then drive away. How do I always end up at this stadium? Drop now. Oh, fight it. Keep you on the track. Road. I need to see if this wheel works with Racing Battle C1. That's one of my favorite SimCade titles. And it's the last one that Genki made. Because even after they did Import Tuner Challenge, which is essentially TXR4 for Xbox 360, they went and made C1 Racing Battle C1. It came out only for Japanese PS2, and it's an excellent game. So I want to see if the wheel works. But I was having trouble with getting it to clone the wheel because those wheels, let's go, okay, we're gonna rally now. Oh, feel all of that. Oh shit. Ah, oh, shit, yeah, don't got rally tires, so it's gonna slip. Don't got their tires. All right, let's just go back to the road. Through the grass. This is what I love about Forza. Horizon. Wait. We're back in the tarmac. Clearly too conservative. Constantly stress testing myself in the wheel by just taking random corners like that to see how well I can make it. Oh, got it. All right, and before my stomach eats my ribs, we are going to call this a day. All right, y'all. So I'm gonna be back on in a few. Once again, if you like what you see here so far, I know it's just still building up content, still building up more stuff, but of course, share it, leave feedback. Definitely want to hear some feedback. What would you like to see? What would you like to see more of? What would you like to see less of? So until then, we are gonna take a short break and return shortly. And that's about it. So guys, thank you for joining in. Thank you for tuning in, and I will be seeing you shortly.